up, guys? It's Johnny Orlando here, and welcome to the behind the scenes of Everybody Wants You.
We're kind of thinking of what we wanted to do, and we didn't really want to do another quarantine video shoot like how we did for CU. So we were essentially just gonna make a lyric video. We started planning things out, and I really want to get a super up for the video. We were kind of thinking, this is gonna be really, really cool. It's almost a shame to dirty the waters with putting lyrics everywhere and have it be branded as a lyric video specifically. The whole point of the video is that I'm kind of lost. I'm in a city, I don't really know the area too well, even in real life. That was what we wanted to portray.
So this was the first video we did, I guess, out of the gates of quarantine, so things were pretty limited and we didn't really know what we were going to be able to do. We had to follow the protocols of, you know, the guidelines of the city and everything. So it means like the number of people you can have on set is really limited. You can't really get close, all those kinds of things. So it was really just sort of a video that we sort of tested the waters and see how it was going to go. So I think knowing that we couldn't really have this huge elaborate story or anything, so we wanted to just do something that was more of a vibe video. Johnny and his team sort of had the idea too that we would always mix in animation to some degree, just because, you know, that's something that you can do that sort of elevates a video, but it's obviously safe. It was definitely, I think, the first time I've tackled an animation project, or at least mixing animation in with live action, and I think it's the first time we've done that for Johnny too.
We thought that we should kind of spice it up a little bit, and one way that I wanted to do that was animation, and I wanted to do it since CU, actually.
It was an exciting challenge to kind of figure out what to choose stylistically to suit the mood of the video and also kind of the timeline that we were working with as well. Something that could capture and kind of exaggerate the vibe that you got from the music and from Johnny himself, and then just enough stylization to give it character and not make it a full like roto video. It was a good experience to find like a marriage between those aspects for sure.
Car battery died. We were looking at the cool lights for too long. Look at that, the car started. Darian doubted me, but you know what the important thing is? Never doubt yourself. They wanna take you.
Like some of the animation we did, like you said, it was sort of piecing assets together and bringing everything to one. But there were specific shots that we did where it was literally frame by frame animated. The entirely what you see is hand animated one frame onto the next frame.
The process pretty much was just like, just getting line work done first and then like finding an accurate but also quick way of coloring it. That we were doing 12 frames per second. On a shot, like it's like the first instance of Johnny and he's in the car and he's turning the wheel and he turns around and blinks, which is also my favorite Johnny shot. That one was like 8 hours.
Yeah.
Like, because all of that, including the background, was frame by frame. Mm. So I painted in the background as well for each frame. 2 seconds, 1.5 seconds, yeah. Is that shot? Like, yeah, like that's like a day of work.
Yeah.
Easily. I love the shot where it's the one where we almost go entirely, the camera almost goes entirely around the car as it spins in.
The video is kind of minimalistic in a way, but it also is big in the same sense that it has all these different like layers and elements, and the animation just sort of is the cherry on top that just kind of pulls it all together and just makes it this really cool vibe video.
Really, really excited and really happy that I was able to do this.